What?
Is that the Hashem? We're gonna, what's it called? We're gonna work on Daf Tzadik Gimel today. Okay. The Gemara says, let's start over from the bottom of Tzadik Bet Amud Bet. Amar Abaye says, Reuven, Shemachar, Sadeh LeShimon. Soli, do me a favor, bring me the Ritva over there. Reuven, Shemachar, Sadeh LeShimon, Reuven sold the field to Shimon. Shelo ba'acharayut, without a harayut. V'yatzu alav iskin, thank you. And there was complaints against the field, claiming that money is owed, or he didn't own it, or whatever the claims are. Ad shelo yechezik ba, before he took possession of it, yachol lahazor bo, he could back out and say, I don't need to get involved in this anymore. Mi shechezik ba, once he got involved, eno yachol lahazor bo, he can't back out of it. Mishum da amar le, because he tells him, haita de ketre, a bag of nuts, savart ve kibilt, you bought a field without a harayut. You were willing to accept problems. You're not, you're taking a risk. Me'ematai mahazikba, what's considered a hazaka? Mechi da'ish amisre, when he went around the daughters to check it out or to inspect it, that's already considered that he took possession. Ika da'amri, others say, afilu ba'acharayut nami, even if he sold it with a harayut, he could back out of it. Why? The amri le, he tells him, ahvet tirfach. Sorry, afilu ba'acharayut Rashi, afilu ba'acharayut nami mecharalo, enu yachalo hazor bo mehamat iskin. Once it starts getting messy, he says, get me out of here. Anyway, you're guaranteeing it. He tells him, no. Enu yachol hazor bo. V'lo amrinan sof sof. Ale hadar. What's the difference? If you pay me now, you pay me later. Ve'atruche dayne lamali. What are we going to make the dayanim crazy for? Da amar le, because he tells him, ach ve'tirfach ve'ashalem lach. Show me the paper that he confiscated from you, and I'll show it, and I'll give it to you. Ach v'tichrach, Rashi. Shtar tirfa mi bedin, a shtar that says it was taken from you. Shekatvu lecha. Sheyatza sadeh miyadecha, that they confiscated the field bedin properly. V'tachazor alay letrof, v'ashalem lach. V'chol zman shelo yatzta miyadcha. Lo ashalem, I don't have to pay. Sharbe oririn she'en zochim bedin. A lot of people come and they complain, and they're not zocheh. So what do you want? You want to get out of court cases? I didn't guarantee you against court cases. I guaranteed you that the field is not going to be... That if they take it, I'll pay you. That's all. So you're a weak target. People like to fight with you. Well, I didn't guarantee that... I didn't guarantee that point. Hold on.
I think you need a shot today, Rabbi.
Oh, today? Maybe we do. Let's see. Let's see. So the Gemara says, we'll start the new Mishnah. Mi shaya nasui shalosh nashim. Someone was married to three ladies. Who met and he died. Ketubata shelzu maneh. One of them, the ketubah, was 100. Veshelzu matayim. And the second one, 200. Veshelzu shalosh mot. And the third one, 300. 1, 2, 3.
The end shop. You get the younger woman every time?
However you want to explain it. Right? All types of flavors, we could explain that. Right?
Rabbi, I had an aunt. Yeah. She buried five husbands.
Shmai Israel.
5. She's still alive.
Wow. ואין זו של 200. ושל זו שלושה. ואין שם אלא מנה. There's only $100 of things to collect from. חולקים בשווה. And that 100, everybody is owed 100. There's $100 to collect from. It's easy to write checks, right? There's no money to cover. So now, three guys present ketubot on the same account with 100. How should they divide it? Should you say, well, you're owed 3, I'm owed 2, you're owed 1, I'm owed 1, owed 1. Let's divide everything into 6 pieces, right? And give proportionately. Is that the way to do it? Or do you say, listen, on the first 100, I'm owed 100 like you're owed 100 like he's owed 100. Right? So we'll give each one a third. Your 300 on this 100, the most you could collect from this 100 is 100. The most the 200 guy could collect from this 100 is 100. The most the 100 guy could collect on the 100 is 100. So because they're all equally have a shibud on it, they split it equally. So again, Holkim Bishaveh, they split it equally. Let's see Rashi. Rashi says, Shelzu Maneh v'Shelzu Matayim v'Shloshtam Nechtemu B'Yom Echad. They all signed on the same day. D'i B'Tlat Yomeh, if they signed on 3 days, HaKodem B'Shtar Kodem B'Gibui. The one who has the earliest shtar collects first. Nah. Holkot b'shave, sharei koach shloshtan shave b'shibud mane de bikulu ika mane. They all have the same amount of shibud against the mane, because they all owe at least the mane. Gemara continues. Hayusham matayim. If there was 200 in the pot, shel mane notelet hamishim. Shel matayim v'shel shlosh meot shelosha shel zahav.
250.
What? So
from
200. So
150
left. So he gets 50, and they get 75 each.
What's the
koach
to get
50? What? What's the koach to get 50? Right?
The same as it was the money 200.
Let's see. Hayu sham 300 shel mane notel 50.
Nishar 250.
Shel 200 mane. The 200 guy takes 100. Veshel 300 shisha shel zahav, he takes 6 gold coins, which is 150. Vechen shelosha she'etilu lekis, if 3 people put the money into a purse to go partners, pichtu o hotiru, if they lost money, or if they gain money, kachen holkim, they divide it according to this ratio.
Oh, there are 2-3 partners between.
What? They're three partners. Rashi. Hayu sham notel hamishim bigmara parich. We're going on the case of 200. When there's 200, the first guy takes 50. The other guys get shalosh shel zahav, shalosha dinre zahav. 3 dinar zahav, v'chol dinar 25. Every dinar zahav is 25 dinar kesef, like it says in Azahav. V'shel matayim, the 200 kohashaveh b'matayim. The 200 has equal rights against the 200, l'ba'alat 300, for the 300 guy. Sharei matayim meshubadim l'shtara. She has a shibur on 200, and that guy has a shibur on 200. Hayu sham 300, if there's 300, Mane Rishon, the first 100, Mishubad Lekula, Mishubad for all. Hashini, the second one, is Mishubad for the Bala Matayim, Bala Shloshmot. Vashlishi lebaalat 300 levada. So we say when there's 300 and the three creditors 100, 200, and 300. Shilmana notela 50. Bigmara palichale. Why should she get
50?
Veshilmatayim mane bigmara mefaresh. Shisha shel zahav hem me'ave 50 zuz. Sheetilu lekis. They put back in the purse. Ma'ot leknot zechora leschar. Kachen cholkim. That's how they divide. Kol echad notel bischar vehefsed lefi ma'otav. Each guy takes in the profit or the loss
proportionate
to his investment. Very nice. Says the Gemara. Shilmaneh. So we're going right away. In the first case, we have there's $600 of ketubah owed. 1, 2, and 3. Number 1, 100. Number 2, 200. Number 3, 300. But there's only $100 to go around. So Gemara says you divide it equally because in this 100, everybody has an equal shibud on it. So therefore, even though your total shibud is 3, in this 100, you're the same as everybody else. So 33, 33, 33. Second case in the Mishnah, it said if there's the same amount, but there's $200 available. So the first one gets 50. So why should you get 50? Hare, according to your calculation, she only has a shibud in the first 100. That's why she divided equally. Once she got 50, once she got 33 from the first one, she's finished. She shouldn't get anything from the second 100. That's why we gave you equal in the first one. Right? So why is...
the second one, I mean the second one and third one...
What?
The second, second 100, only the second and third take.
Right. But you should have given 33, and then the second two should get 83 and 83. Why not? That's the lumdus. The lumdus is we're all equal, so on what we all have a shibud, we share equally. Your third 100
should be paid up until 100. What's the difference? How much he get? He has. She's supposed
but
to get paid.
Getting,
I understand. Everybody's losing. How are we dividing up the loss? So either you say I take the whole thing and I pay cents on the dollar, which they're not saying. They're saying in this 100, the three of you get a piece. Now your shibud we only put on 100. Now the second 100, since we're dividing them at one shot, that's what we do. The second 100 we divide among the two people that have a shibud on 200, and the third 100 goes all to the guy that has a shibud on 300. So in theory, when there's 300, you would say
second one's not getting anything, so what? The third one's getting 100.
No, the second one's still getting. She has until two. Oh, she's only 200 of the first.
Yeah, so yeah. 300. The third one take the whole 300.
Right. Mm-hmm. So she'll take 100, 180, 183. Mm-hmm. That's what you would think, but it doesn't come out like that. Mishnah changes it. And if there's 400, well, the 300 is going to get it all or no? Because it's 400, they're all mishubat on that?
If there's the Mishnah doesn't tell us.
What do you do when he's at 400?
So the 400 divide by all of them again,
again
no?
Start again?
Looks like it.
I don't know. I don't know.
So
we have hard enough time. We're going to have hard enough time explaining this.
Okay.
So the Gemara says...
there's still a loss because there's 100, 200, and 300, 600.
When you say the first,
the first hundred,
you tell me 33, 33, 33, right?
That's the first case.
Yeah. Let's
the first 100, right?
And the second 100 is 50, 50.
And
the third 100 over there. Who's the 400 go to?
You go to the casino and you win the
dice. Okay, that's around where I'm holding. Why? Tlatin v'tlata v'tiltahu de'itla. She should only have 33 and a third. Amar Shmuel. You know why she's getting 50? Bekotevet ba'alat matayim. The ba'alat maneh, the one that has 200, wrote to the 100 one, dinu dvarim en li imach b'maneh. I don't have any arguments with you about the first 100. So it's almost like she removed herself from the first 100.
Who, the first one?
The second one to the first one.
The second one removed herself from the first 100.
She's
no. She's not. So now who's splitting the first 100? the Baalat Maneh and the Baalat Shloshmeot. So it's 50-50.
Why are you
saying that?
Why?
He omitted la.
He told her.
She said, "Dinu dvarim en liv imach b'maneh." Ihachi, ihachi. If so, ema seifa. Look at the seifa. Shel matayim v'shel shloshmeot shalosh shel zahav. They each get 75. Why? Why? You decided to give your portion over to her, right?
Why she's getting her half also? The third one, you mean?
The second one
told the first one take my portion.
So then, leave me. Why should I lose because you decided to be magnanimous?
She should get only 50.
Get, in the second one, right? Get 50.
What do you care? I do anything I want with my money.
No problem. Don't do what you want with your money. Don't do with my money.
My money, my third. According to what he says, my third.
Rega, rega.
Now she's fighting with the third.
What? Now when she goes to the second 100, she's taking. Where'd you get 25 from? In the second 100, get 50.
But the third wife, she splits 50.
Right. The first 100, I had 33. I told the first one, I have nothing to do with you. It's good. So she's gonna get what?
66 and 33, whatever.
No,
two-thirds and a third.
Did I give her my portion?
It's a question.
If I gave her my portion, she should be getting 66.
She's not mevatet to the first one. One second.
I was mevatet to the first one, not to the second one.
What do you mean the first one? It's nothing to do with you.
On the border?
It's mevatet by case.
One second. If I said I'm not fighting over the first 100, so who fights? One and three.
Yes. No, but she only said it to one. She didn't say it to three.
Very good. Exactly what you want to happen. So one is getting 50, three is getting 50. Now we come.
That doesn't make sense.
Why not?
She's saying, I'm not fighting with you, you take mine. So one's getting 60.
Not saying you take mine.
Now that doesn't work because Mishnah says she gets 50. But Meman of Shach. So the Mishnah says she gets 50. So you have to say, she's saying, I'm not fighting, you two fight. Look at Rashi.
Look what she's saying.
Right, tlatim v'tlat tiltahu deitla. The haynu shlish shel maneh. She should get a third of the maneh. Share in la chelik b'maneh sheni. She has no portion in the second one. Dinu dvari en li yimach b'maneh. I have nothing to do with you in the 100. Kishetavoy ledin. When you come to judgment, lo arivi yimach b'maneh amishubad lach. I'm not going to fight with you about your 100. V'lo yitmaet chelkech. Your portion should not be lessened b'shvili because of me. Chelkech. He who ba'alat shlosh mot cholkum noto. The one and the three divide the first 100. So now the Mishnah says, "V'teimala hasal kat nafshach misham." Look at Rashi. "V'teimala ba'alat shloshmo leba'alat matayim hasaliket nafshach mimane." You cut yourself out of the first one. "V'en lach lichalek ela b'mane sheni." Shown by the second one, 50-50. So I should get, 100. You get 50, and she gets 50. You decided to be nice. Leave me out of it. Right?
Number three says to number two, mishum, to do with
mishum
your,
de amra la, because she told her, midinu dvarim hu desalikin nafshai. Rashi, midinu dvarim hu desalikin nafshai. Lo natati chelki b'matana. I didn't give it as a present. Uma shegavta, what she collected 50, lo b'shlichuti gavta. She didn't collect it because I told her to. She tomar li, natla zu chelkecha. She took your portion. No, she didn't take my portion. Ani silakti atzmi milariv ima. I stopped fighting with her. Umilamaet chelka b'mane. V'gavar yada. So she won. Ligbot hasia mane b'shibut shtara. So she collected half of it with her lead. Achshav ani ba'al lahlok imach benotar. Now that she got 50.
The first one.
And I didn't fight with her. Now I'm fighting with you about 150. And we're equal on the 150. No. Yeah.
What do you mean equal on 150?
Meaning.
It should be 50, 33, 16.6, so 17 for the first 100.
How long is that?
She's going to split her 33 and give it to one, but she wants the balance of the first 33.
She's pulling out
of the first 100, she gets 33. So she's giving away 17 of it.
Why do you say that?
Because that's what she just said.
No.
She just said, I'm not fighting with her.
She's saying, I'm not fighting with her, but I'm fighting with you.
Right.
Very good. So I'm fighting with you on what's left after she takes.
I was right.
Does she have to take 50?
1 second. When we come to... Why not? She came to fight only with you. She fought with you. She took her 50. Right? Now what's left?
What's the 17?
150. On that 150, I want to fight with you. Now, what's funny is, like Albert's saying, it comes out that by me choosing not to fight with number one and to fight with number three, so I am reducing number three's stake. And we said in the last Mishnah that the Yitomim don't have the right to say Harenu Ma'alim Al Dameha Maneh in order to reduce what's good, in order to take the Ketubah Benin Dechrina and not go to what's good. So why does it work over here? Tosafot says the Amra Lami Dinu Dvarinu Desalki Loi Paresh Shapir Ta'ama Deha Milta. It's not so clear exactly why this works. I assume he means why it's not the same as the case before. It could be that in the case before, you're trying to add something that's not there. I'm just not fighting. It could be that there's some sort of alumnus that you could say to divide it. The Ritva actually says that the third one was also involved and she agreed to the deal, and that's why it works like this. This is, and if not, it works like Albert. 50, and I get 63 and the third, and the other one gets 133 and the third. Now, continue. If there was $300 available.
113.
Yes.
Doesn't work.
63 and 133 is already 160 something. 200. Yeah, only 200.
67, 50.
The total is 200.
83.
67.
Okay, sorry. Hayusham. Hayusham, sorry, bad man. Hayusham shlosh meot. Hayusham shlosh meot. If there's 300. So we said it's 50, 100, and 150. Now, again, the math should not work like that.
100.
Each money is fought by itself.
Wow. The second 100?
Yeah.
How come you're 100? Wow. 50 from the second one.
It's amazing. On the third 100, right? How's she getting anything?
Yeah, that's the question.
How'd she get more than 75?
It's
amazing. The law of increasing returns. Right? So, Hayusham Shlosh Meot Shel Matayim Maneh. 75 hu de'itla. She has the same 75, meaning assuming that she bowed out to the first one, she should have the same 75.
No, 50
only.
50
and
25. Only 50?
No.
Left
now. No, 1 second. And if she bowed out to the first one in the first money, right? So we said, first one gets 50, she gets 75, the other one gets 75. Now there's a third 100, she go all to the third one. Right?
What is going to the 300?
The 300 goes there because I don't have a sheep on the 300. Number two only has a sheep on 200. Number one. Very good. So the 300 should go all to number three. So she should have 175, 75, and 50. Says the Gemara. Amar Shmuel bekotevet ba'alat 300. Leba'alat 200 ulba'alat maneh. Dinu dvarim en li'imachem bemaneh. It's the new case. The number three wrote to one and two, I have nothing to do with you in the money. No, number one, number two didn't say anything. Number three said something in this case.
Number three has to say it twice because the first money is everybody.
She tells it to the two of them. I'm not fighting with either one of you.
But the second money is a different fight.
What?
The second money is a different fight.
Yeah.
She tells the first one, I have nothing to do with you.
What's that?
Second. La shenia vela rishuna yoyendin vidva.
What? No, I'm not for the first 100. I'm not fighting with you. So the first 100, they split equally.
The second
100, they split 50-50. So now number one got 100, not got 50. Number two got 100, and number three gets 150. The first one, second, third one was mivatir.
50, 100.
They must have gotten along in that house, right? Okay. Rashi. Amar Shmuel Sefer Bekotev Ba'alat Shlosh Mot Ubaalat Matayim Lo Katva Klum. She didn't say anything. Hilkach, Mane Rishon Holeket Baalat Mataim Ubaalat Mane. The one and two split. Right? Ubaalat Mane. Baalat Mane. Mane Sheni, the second one.
50-50.
Holeket Baalat Mataim Ubaalat Shloshmot. Mane Shlishi Kular Baalat Shloshmot. Tosafot says, "Bekotev ba'alat shlosh meot lo yada Rabbi my kamash malamat niti." So what's the chiddush of such a mishnah? She wrote. You're coming up with these around the ear cases. The Gemara continues. Rabbi Yaakov minahar pekod mishmed Ravina amar reisha b'shtetefisot v'seifa b'shtetefisot. The reisha is talking where they got the properties in two shots. And the Seifa is talking where they got the property in two shots, but different denomination shots. Watch. So he says, Reisha, meaning 50 and 75, 75. Tenavlu 75 behad zimna, ume'a ve'esrim v'hamisha behad zimna. The first one, right? In the first case, they fell, in the second case, fell 75 and 125. So when 75 fell, everybody took 25, 25, 25. Case closed. So how much is left? How much is left now in the shtarot? 75?
75, you
175 and 275, right? Now, 125 fools. The first 75 of the 125, they all have a shiburon. So, right?
25 each, she gets 50.
Why does one have a shiburon more than 25 more?
Because every time you go to a collection, right? So you see how much is left on your note. But when you finish writing, when you finish the collection, what are they subtracting? Your whole note? No. You come with a note, it says, from 100 it was paid 25. From 200 it was paid 25. From 300 it was paid 25. Now, 2 weeks later, they do more discovery. They find another property, 125. So from that, in that property, divide, take out 75. That's the chidush of the Mishnah, that you look at it like this. Right? No, so now, 25, 25, 25. So number one gets 50. Number two has 50. Number three has 50. Everybody has 50. Now there's another 50 left. Right? The 50 left, they both have a shiburon. I have 175, you have 275. We're both equal. Split it equally. 25, 25. So therefore, we both got 75. Number two and three both have 75. Rashi. Tenaflu la'ayin hei b'had zimna. Ubau ladun alehem. Amrinan lehu. Holko b'shave, split it equally. Share shibud shloshtam al mane. Each one has a shibud al mane, which is more than the whole amount. Umane ve'esrim v'hamisha b'had zimna. So therefore, ba'alat mane, the one who's owed 100, far gavta kafhei. Ubat lariv al ayin hei, she has a shibud on all 75. Hilkach ayin hei, the first 75, mishubadim l'kulan, as mishubad to all of them. V'cholkin otan, they divided. Everybody has 50. The amotar and the rest of it in the ba'alat maneh helik bo. The ba'alat maneh
is coming to argue for 75. She only has 50 balance. She can argue for 50.
What are you talking about? The ba'alat maneh.
Yeah. Oh, sorry, 100.
No problem. Either way, but there's it's all there. Okay. Right, she has 175 balance before she starts, right? Right, and the ba'alat maneh chelik bo. Haynu dekamar shel 200 v'shel 300 shelosha shelosha shel zav. Seifa b'shtei tefisot. Let's see back inside. V'seifa b'shtei tefisot. Seifa b'shtei tefisot. Denaflu 75 b'had zimna. 75 fell once. U'matayim v'esrim v'chamisha b'had zimna. And 225 in one shot. So what happened? 75, they got 50-50-50. The next 225, the first 75 was... First 75 was 25-25. So everybody has 50. Now, on the next... Of the 225 that fell, 175 was mishubat to the second guy. So the first 75, they split 25-25. On the next 100, they split 50-50. So number 2 has 100. And number 3 has 100. The next 50 all belongs to number 3. You got it? From the 225 that fell, or we'll go backwards. From the 225 that fell, 50 is clean to the third guy. So he takes 50. Now he has 75. Right? 75, you split three ways. Right? So that goes, that makes everybody at 50, and he's at 100. The next 100, you split 50-50, and therefore it's 50, 150, 150, 100, 150. Beautiful. Says the Gemara, Tanya, we learn, Zumishnat Rabbi Natan. This is the way Rabbi Natan used to do it. Rabbi Omer, En ani ro'ed dvarav shel Rabbi Natan be'elu, ela holkot b'shaveh. They split it all equally.
Percentage.
Equally.
Equally
with the percentage, no? Rashi, En ani ro'ed dvarav shel Rabbi Natan be'elu. She'en ze dome l'shlosha she'etilu lakis. It's not like three people that invest. Tehatam shevach ma'ot sheshbichu ma'otehem. Right, the Mishnah says the same. That's the same way they divide investments proportionally according to investment. Says that's because you're talking about how much their money made. Shekle she tehatam shevach ma'ot sheshbichu ma'otehem. Shachli they're taking. Hilkach kol echad yitol kefi ma'otav. Everybody takes proportionate to investment. Aval hacha ta'ama mishum shibudes, because you have a shibudu. We say in the ketubah, everything you have is mishubah to my ketubah. So until my ketubah is paid in full, I have a shibud on everything you have. So therefore, everybody collects equally until I'm paid off.
Equally, which means what?
So therefore means you have...
The first 100.
Yeah, the first 100, 33. If there's 200... Then everybody gets 66. If there's 300, everybody gets 100. Ah, I have more, you have less. Tough luck.
Then after that,
then they split it 50-50.
After that,
third,
right.
Karl Marx.
Then you paid off my loan.
No, the one is out, that's it.
One is out, but they do 50-50 on the
rest. Yeah, 300, that's it.
They're not getting paid cents on the dollar, according to Rebbe, either. We're splitting equally until
the 600.
Second one is paid.
So until there's 500...
The third one's still losing.
Right.
Yeah. Is this the foundation for communism?
Right. So
the one with the until the 600 comes.
So the one with the money always never lose. Hello, no, you're not supposed to kill the same. Give me 100. Oh, we're happy when you go to kill the much.
Oh, we're
by percentage.
Women do.
When you have partners,
but he's saying it's not a business deal. Yeah. That's the reason.
Women know how to sue them.
Tosafot says, "Here's Rabbeinu Chananel, Kaimalan beha hilchetaki Rebbe, v'yiv shala amid devarav, de bizman sheyesham shlosh meot. If there's 300, holko b'shaveh, ba'alat me'a, ba'alat matayim me'a, ba'alat shlosh mo me'a, lefi shemidat adin lokeh."
So the first
says
one,
it's not fair.
No, because the first one
I'm
got,
losing much more than you.
Yeah.
So therefore,
yes, it does.
Ella,
the third one is losing the most.
Right. Ella, he'emadnu divrei Rebbe. We think Rebbe means she'amar she'holko b'shaveh kol maneh u'maneh notelet b'shaveh. Every maneh they take equally. Hilkach cholkim kol ezvon amet b'shisha halakim. We divide everything into six portions. Shel maneh notel chelek echad, shel matayim shnei halakim, v'shel shlosh mod gimel halakim. Kol ahad notel v'rim ma'oteha, ad shetifra kol ahad ketubata. In everything they find, they take proportionally. Ki zeh din sedek, v'zeh she'amar Rabbi, en ani ro'eh dvarav be'elu. Not in babad reisha, not in babad mesia. Aval b'seifa. I like the Seifa. And the Seifa, right, which is 50, 100, 150, that's six pieces.
It's the same.
That's what Rabbeinu Chananel is claiming. Rebbe says, En ani ro'ed v'rav shel Rebbe be'elu is A and B. 100 and 200. I like your 300 thing, and I want you to do that all over.
So then we don't penalize. That's a Jew. So you
want to
say
Tachua din confirm. Okay, that's Tosos Pshat. That's where he's going from Ben Hanan. Okay, next. Says the Gemara, Vechen, if it was interesting until now, it gets more. Vechen Shlosha Sheetilu Lekis. Amar Shmuel. Shmuel says, Shnaim Sheetilu Lekis. Two people that put money in a purse to buy, to invest. This guy put 100, this guy put 200. They split the profits equally. Rashi holkim b'shave. Amar Rabba. Rabba says, Mistabra milta de Shmuel. What Shmuel says makes sense. B'shor laharisha ve'omed laharisha. Right? They took the 300. They bought a shor for harisha. Right? And they're renting it out. So, as much as I own, right? I own less, I own more. Let's say you own two legs, three legs, I own one leg. Right? How much are you getting for sure with three legs? Zero. Right? So now, it's like the shopping cart that has one wheel that goes the wrong way. You know, it's worthless. So now, you have a shor that's not worth it. So without my thing, you can't get anything. So I'm equal than like you.
Without my 2%,
you don't want. I drive a hard bargain. You okay? Rent it out. Rent it out. Rent it out and don't use my leg. Rent it out and don't use my leg.
You own the car. You own the keys. So you own the keys. You own the car.
Right.
Half and half.
Half and half. Now you're learning how to be a businessman, Chad. Without my box, you can't ship.
I'm the other side. I'm the one that's putting two-thirds. I don't want to...
Listen.
Nus benus.
Aval. B'shor laharisha. Ve'omed letibiha. If the shor is for plowing, and you're butchering it...
Three legs is worth.
Zenotel afi ma'otav. Zenotel afi ma'otav.
They're selling it.
Right, Rashi. Shola harisha shelach ubaim shola harosh vechorshim bo. Ve'en helko shel zeh mu'il belo helko shel zeh. Your part don't work with my part, right? You have the item, I got the batteries, right? Klum hilkach holkim b'shaveh. Aval shola harisha ve'eshbiach b'basar u'b'shachatu. If you have a shola harisha and the meat went up and therefore they slaughtered it, zeh natilafi ma'otav. You're dividing it up by pieces.
If you're selling it, you're getting it
apart. So what's the chidush? Why do you say that in the beginning they started off a plowing? Rabu Tashwin, it's a chidush. Even though when they got involved, the intention was to divide it equally because you were planning on renting it out. Right, hashta the sheva bebasar. Since the meat went up, v'shehatu v'metchalek levarav, you're dividing the pieces. He told ish lefim autav. That's what Rabbi says. Rav Amnuna Amar, afilu shol harisha ve'omed letibiha. Even a shor for harisha, and you're butchering it. Hasachar leemtza, the profits go to the middle. Meiti ve, I'll ask you a question. Matey, I'll ask you a question. Let's see what the logic is.
Even though they make a deal, Rabbi?
They make a deal, they make a deal. I call the feet in our.
They don't only cool, they have three, two legs, three legs. They have one leg, one leg.
By the Jews,
since they bought it for harisha, so they knew they were splitting the profits equally. So therefore, even if the profits are coming from the etzim, once you agree to split them equally, split the profits equally, you take your money, I'll put money in. Shani Omer, Kikishin Mlukulat Vichal, Data Rishonaya, Shia Halku Arevak Lemsa, Vabisholat Vicha, Vermedla Tivicha. So the problem is the Gemara coming up later. לטעמה דמילתא, so how come? אבל הוא עדין בשול לתביכה ועומד לתביכה, שכר לאמצע עד שיעשו תנאי מפורש. They have to put in the operating agreement that we're going to split the profits according to investment. טעמה דמילתא, משום דמזלה דבית רי עדיף. Two people mazal is more powerful. ושכרה נתרפה, and they're making more money, מפני חלקו המועט, של זה שיכולים לקח סחורה גדולה יותר. Says if you would have started with your 100, right? So you'll make profit at a lower rate. Now that I added 50 on top, says now the profit rate went up, so therefore we split it equally, unless you say so. They're both working.
They're both working. I like the partners who one shows up later with and tells them, oh, you should make more than you. Tells them, no, my mother is making more than you. No, they're both working here.
Okay. Says the Gemara, Meiti, I'll ask you a question. Meiti, Shnaim Shetilu Laki, Zemane, Zematai, Maschar, Leemza. Two people that invested in a business, right? 100 and 200, they split the money equally. My love, aren't we talking Bishola Harisha Ve'omel Tevicha? When they invested for Tevicha, for plowing, and now you're butchering it. The Tiyuv Tadaraba, who said that in that case he split the fee ma'otav. I said, no, not so clear. Shor la harisha ve'omed la harisha. Shor for harisha, that's omed la harisha. But shor la harisha. No problem. Who says it's talking about tibicha? Maybe it's talking about harisha. And like we said, you can't plow with three legs. Aval shor la harisha ve'omed la tibicha mai. So what's going to be if he wants to butcher it? Don't tell if he's ma'otav. So then they're going to split it according to the investment. Adetani sefer. What does the sefer of that braita say? Lakach ze b'shelo v'ze b'shelo. If each guy bought their own animals, v'nit arvu, and they got mixed together, and then they sold them, ze no tel if he ma'otav. Then each guy takes according to his investment. Why? Because they never agreed to become partners. Live log v'lit nibidide. Why don't you give a difference even when they became partners? B'medvarim umurim, then they split it equally. Fishol laharisha v'omed laharisha. If you bought it for plowing and you're plowing with it, and like we said, you can't plow with three legs, so we split the money equally. Aval bishol laharisha v'omed latibicha. But if you bought it for plowing and now you're butchering it, zeh no telefim ma'otav. Each guy should take according to his money. What do you have to jump to the case where they're not even they never really became partners? Says Gemara Hachinami Kama. That's exactly what we meant to say. Bamedvarim Amurim. Read it like this. Bamedvarim Amurim. That you split it equally. Bishol laharisha v'omei laharisha. When you bought it for plowing and it's plowing and you can't plow with three legs, so split it. Aval bishol laharisha v'omei latibicha. But if you bought it for plowing, but you're butchering it, Na'asa, it's the same as kimisha lakach zeh b'shelo v'zeh b'shelo v'netarvu. That's the same as each guy has his own invest, his own piece. And they got mixed up by mistake. Well, you can't claim to do it. There's no partnership, and there's no reason to split it equally. Zeno telefi ma'otav, zeno telefi ma'otav. Tanan, come to our Mishnah. V'chen shlosha she'tilu l'kis. Three people invested in a purse. Pachtu ohotiru, if they went down or they went up. Kachen holkim. They divide the same way. It's tefi ma'otav. My love, pachtu mamash. Hotiru mamash doesn't mean it went down, meaning they lost money. It went up, they gained money. Rashi, pachtu mamash, v'katani kachen chokim lefi ma'ot, v'tiyuvta de Shmuel. L'chaora, look in Tosvot. My love, pachtu mamash, v'kasavar b'shol laharisha v'omed letibicha ayri. Right? Those will argue on Rashi. Says it's Shola Harisha no Mele Tebicha.
The guy could be saying all his.
And therefore. And it's a Tiyuvta only on Rav Hamnuna, according to Tosvot. Right? Because at least in some case of an investment where there's a Chidush, you divide on the Fima Otav. Says Gemara lo. Amar Rav Nachman, Amar Rabba Baravua lo. Hotiru Zuze Hadate. Pachtu Astira Detsunita. Hotiru means they got better money. Rashi zuze hadete, shematilim zuzim yeshanim. They put in old money, worn out. Venasu, venatnu, venasu bahim. And they did business. Achenasu hadashim. Till they got money that's brand new.
And don't believe that it's good.
Now, you know, this is not, we're not talking about new dollar bills. You get new dollars in the bank. You take one with scotch tape and you get a new double. The old days, the coins, the gold was the value. So you get an old coin, you have to take it to the avad because it's actually missing some gold. Right? It weighs less. So their profit in the business was that they got full coins, like Obel HaSoher, like Abraham gave Ephron. Right? You split it the same way. You put in 100, you get back 100. Say, no, your 100 was really 95, and my 50 was really 44. And now we're gonna calculate what was how much it really weighed less than the face value and divide up that split equal. No, that went out the wrong. That they agree to split equally. The kohad might be Aif Shakil. I'm taking what I put in. I'm not taking profit really. Avale motiru yoter ala hashbon. But if you put in 600 and there's 601, the one gets split three ways. And what's pichtu estira ditzunita shenifsela matbea? They wound up converting it from one coin to another coin, and then the coin that they got became contraband, right? The king that issued that coin was conquered, and now the other king said nobody's allowed to use that coin. I hate my enemy. So now you have to use
devaluation.
You have to use it only in black market deals, and you lose a certain percentage for that. Rashi, istira ditzunita shenefsela matbea ve'en yotze botzah umi sheyesh lo, one that has a makeh bepisat raglo, he smashes it mehamat koshe mitachat koshe sham de maale le haluda didhu. You make it.
Copper.
Mihem.
Different color. No?
Taha. Mishi eshlo makas. Oh, sorry, Michiel, I read it wrong. Mishi eshlo makas bepisat raglo. If you have a wound on the bottom of your foot, kosher mehem sham, you put it over there. The ma'al yale haluda ditu, vitsurta ditu. The coin helps to get rid of the coin. Yosim besela shala tzinit. My tzinit bat ara. It's a corn. Or the given the yesh no ve'ayin. No tell kol ehad ke hashbon she. It's there. You take the same thing, even though there's a loss in it. So you can't disprove Shmuel. You can't prove Shmuel. It's everything is loss. Mi shaya nasui dalet nashim. Someone who was married to four wives. Umet and he died. Okay. Who said he had four mother-in-laws? Umet and he died. Harishona kodemet lishnia. Vishniya lishlishit vishlishit lirviit. Rashi. Harishona. So why? He married them sequentially. So the one that's kituba is first, she collects first. After she finishes collecting, the second one collects. When she, because now they date at different times. Now, Lachaura, he died. They're collecting from each one that collects is causing the other one to lose. Right?
Unless one of them dies, then there's enough money that to...
If there's not enough, when I collect, I'm causing you to lose. When you collect, you're causing the other two to lose. Why? Because what I'm taking is off the table. So the Mishnah says, Harishona nishbat. The first one has to swear. Harishona nishbat lishniya. She has to swear to the second one that what she took was all justified. Vishniya lishlishi. The second one swears to the third one. Vishlishid lirviit, because each one is considered like a creditor against them.
What's the shivu afra?
Then you're taking. Maybe he gave you some money before, and you're not owed the whole ketubah.
Let's say everything's okay. So
you never know.
1 second. You're owed 200. I'm owed 200. You're coming to take your 200 first. I say no. I know that he gave her money before. Swear that he didn't give you any money in advance.
Okay, let's say nobody gave anything. So the fourth one have to wait. Everybody receives their money.
Shivu.
What do you mean? No. My date is first.
How come you did it first? The first one.
I'm the first wife.
Yeah.
I am the señora.
So everybody waits for me to get all my...
So I get... Because my date is first. Yes, the other case, they're all on the same date. Rashi,
how come the same date?
She was the first
one. He married three girls in one day?
The first time he got married, the other one, yeah, he married three on one day.
Three in one day he married.
Oh, they all,
and they got
they
different ketubahs.
They lost the ketubah and they wrote him and they didn't have dates. He never, I don't know, whatever the case was.
Okay,
whatever. They were all
mochilic. Whoever's first, getting first.
They prepared the ketubah. Right, Rashi said they're all on the same day over there.
He prepared the ketubah on the same day.
Harishona nishbal l'shniya, im shniya to'enet ho'il ve'ad ba'ali tol techila. Because you're taking first. He shav'i li, swear to me, shelo gavi mishel ba'ali klum, that you didn't take anything from my husband.
Who? Her husband. Sure.
Ready?
Yeah, now it's your husband.
Dilma, Dilma lo mishtayir li. Well, he picked me over you. Yeah. Dilma lo Dilma, Dilma, you want a cat fight, Jack? Come into Bedin that day. Right? Dilma lo mishtayir li nechasim. Maybe there won't be enough left. Kishi'ur ketubati. Vav shlishit, tomar ken lishni, av revi'it lishlishit. Aval arvi'it. Nifrat shelo b'shva. Why? Kegon shayetomim gedolim. The yetomim are gedolim. Ve'kasavar haitana ki amru rabbanan. When did the chachamim say abali paran min nechse yetomim lo yifra lo b'shva only by yetomim kitanim, but not by gedolim? Because the gedolim would know more about their father's business. So again, let's read inside. Harishona nishbad lishnia. The first ones were harishona nishbad lishnia. Shnia lishlishi. Shlish. The vir vi nifrat shelo b'shva. Ben nanas. Omer, v'chi mepene, she aharona niskeret, because she's the last one. She gains. Afi lo tefra el b'shua.
What?
Whoa, what?
The class?
Rashi. Ubigmara mefaresh pluktai ubemai. What are they arguing about? Hayu yotzot kulam biyom ehad, if they're all on the same day, kol hakodemet lahavirta. Afilu sha'a ahad zachta. The Tana holds. Whoever got married first on the day, yours is at 10 o'clock, mine is 11, yours is 12, mine is 1. Zachta, you get first. Rashi. Kilomar yotzol lefanenu. Umilamdot shekula nechdavo biyom echad, b'sha'a ahad b'ktubata zachta. Imesha'o mefurashot. If it says it in the ketubah. Kigon b'ha katu biyom bloni b'sha'a shlishi. B'sha'a arvi'it v'chem b'kulan.
The case is we don't know who get married first?
If it says,
day, but
it
we don't
says,
know
first. It says.
Yeah.
B'shlishi b'shabbat, b'sha'a eser v'boker.
And he married 11 o'clock and 12 o'clock.
Right. Very, very busy day, Jack. What a honeymoon.
What is out of the four, two are twins and they look alike. And you don't know which one is what.
They have names.
V'en sham.
They have names, but they can fool you with the names.
V'en sham elamane. Hayu kulam yotzim b'sha'a ha v'en sham elamane. Holko b'shaveh. Then they divide it equally. Baruch Adonai le'olam. Amen.